Kakalosh Boker Tov, we're going to continue Bezerat Hashem with Davkuf Yutet Amud Aleph, 119A1. So basically, we finished off yesterday by saying on Kuf Yutet Amud Bet on the bottom that Abaye came and he said, Teti li, ya should get reward, b'chichazina tzubem rabbanan d'shalim misichta, because when I see the rabbis that they finish a siyum mesechet, that they finish a gemara, avin na yom atav el rabbanan, I make a big siuda and a yom tov for the rabbis. So I'm a rabba. Rabbi comes and he says, right? You should know that when the rabbis come in front of me, in front of a bedin, right? I don't put my head on the pillow until I start going back and forth, trying to find some zechut, right, in his din. Okay, which means that he used to try to do even more, right? Why? Because he didn't want to suspect that a Talmid Chacham was going against halacha. So therefore, he was trying to go backwards and forwards and all these things. So Amar Amar Ravashi Pasina Letzuber Rabbanan Ladina. He says, "I am pasul to a Talmid Chacham in the judgment." He says, "Why, my Tama? The Chaviv Alai Kegufai. They're so precious to me, Talmid Chachamim, that it's like myself." Ben Adam Roechov Aletzmo. A person will never see something negative with himself. Meaning, we always see ourselves in a positive light, not never in a negative light. So therefore, that's why I'm pasul to any rabbi. Chanina used to put on beautiful clothing on Erev Shabbat and used to say, Shabbat Malka, that's the Lechadodi. Right, we're coming out to greet Shabbat Malka. Right, this is the next part, which is Boikala Boikala, that he used to say. So we stopped with all the Teitilis and we went to the next one, which is going back to Kavod Shabbat. Remember, the concept of Teitili was, is that we're telling us that we were extra observant in certain mitzvot, and therefore we should get a certain reward. And it's true, every single rabbi used to have a certain midah that they were experts in, or they used to try to focus in 100%, and that was their mitzvah, that was their yesod that they used to try to do all the time, to be most cautious with. Okay? Rabba Baravuna ikla lebe Rabba Bar Nachman. Rabbi Rav Huna once came to visit the house of Rabbi Rav Nachman. They brought him three se'im, right, which was full of, se'im is a measurement, right? Full of shemen. Amalu, he said, Mihabi yadituna datina. Says, what, you knew that I was coming? Amrule, they said, Mi'adif lamine. Says, what, are you better than Shabbat? That means, even if we didn't know you were coming to our house on Shabbat, Shabbat in itself is already enough to start making a lot of food and start preparing, start making a beautiful meal. Forget about that we knew guests about non-guests. Rabbi Abba Zavim placed a strip, Shita B'Zisa B'Tlisa Tabeche. Rabbi Abba used to buy 13 different types of foods, okay, in order that you should have the best one for Shabbat. U'mashlim lehu atzinar adedasha. And he used to bring the meat to the entrance of his house, right? And he wouldn't go inside the house in order to go to the next tabach. Amalu, and he used to tell them, Ashur haya, Ashur haya. Right? Quickly prepare it, right, while I'm coming with the next meat. Meaning on Erev Shabbat, it used to be one after another. Ta, 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 again, again, and again, and again. Why? Because he used to go bring meat. He wouldn't even get into the house. He used to give it to them. Go cook it. But make sure you do it quickly, because I'm coming back with more meat. He used to go to the next one. So imagine here in Miami, you would go to every single store, buy meat, and the best one you're going to use for Shabbat. Okay? Rabbi Avu Avu Yativ A Tachtaka Deshina Moshif Nura. Rabbi Avu used to sit down on a moshav of Shinhav. I don't know how you translate that in English.
A stool of ivory.
Ivory.
And fans the fire.
Right, the fans the fire. Okay. Right? Why? Because I guess... because that way they used to actually quicken the cooking process from Erev Shabbat. Okay? Rav Anan Lavish Gunda. Rav Anan used to put a Gunda, which is basically the Gavim Shechorim, right, on Erev Shabbat, in order that basically people shouldn't, how do you call it, that, you know, that he shouldn't get dirty. Because why? He has to prepare for Shabbat. So he used to put on, you know, black clothing, and he doesn't care if it's going to get dirty. The Tanya Dvev Ishmael, the Gavim Shebisheba in Kedral Rabo, because the clothing that you're using to cook for your master, you're not going to use afterwards to put them on. So therefore, he used to put on regular clothing, cook and prepare on Erev Shabbat, and then on Shabbat he used to come with beautiful clothing. Rav Safra, Echarech Reisha, Rav Safra used to come and burn with himself, right? He used to burn the head of the animals that he used to prepare them for Shabbat. Echarech Be'atzmo is used to take off, you know, like the hairs and all these things from the head of the animals. Rava Malach Shibuta, Rava used to come and used to salt a fish called Shibuta, right? Which here it says, okay, it's a certain type of a fish. Okay, Rav Huna and Madlik Sharger, Rav Huna used to light the candles lichot Shabbat. Rav Papa Gadil Petilta used to come and used to prepare the wicks of the Shabbat. Rav Chasta Parim Silka used to cut the, you know, the vegetables, right? Or here it says silka, which is like spinach into small pieces. Rabbi Rav Yosef used to come and used to cut the wood themselves for lichot Shabbat. Rabbi Zera Metzata Tzitute, Rabbi Zera used to put on the wood, he used to light the fire himself. So if you see from here that no matter how great of the rabbis they were, they all did something lichot Shabbat. It didn't exist that they just did nothing. They always did something lichot Shabbat.
So it's a mitzvah to taste the food?
Of course. Erev Shabbat is a mitzvah. Tomei Chaim Zachu, there's a mitzvah to taste the food. Erev Shabbat of Shabbat.
Uh-huh.
Mitzvah. Tomei, the ones that taste it, Chaim Zachu, they will merit Chaim, they will merit life.
Okay.
Okay. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak Michata Vayin. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak used to come and used to bring things in the house. Rav Efek used to take things out of the house lichot Shabbat. Amar, he said, Iklu Mikalin li Rabbi Yami Rabbi Asi. He says, what? If Rabbi Yami Rabbi Asi would come to visit me, I wouldn't come and move the things around in my house. Meaning, if you have big rabbis coming to your house, you're obviously going to move the things around. Certain things which shouldn't be in the house, you'll put them in the backyard. Certain things which are outside, you're going to bring them in. You're going to move things around. You want to make it presentable. Same thing for Shabbat. Yikadam, and some people say it was Rabbi Yami Ravasi used to do this. And they used to say, if Rabbi Yochanan used to come inside to visit us, we wouldn't do this for Rabbi Yochanan, obviously. Yotzi Mokir Shabbat, Hahu Nochri Bishvuvote. This is a very famous Gevara, which is in his storybooks, of Yosef Mokir Shabbat. Rabbi Yosef, he wasn't even a Rav. It was called Yosef Mokir Shabbat, right? There was a right. He used to be Mechabed Shabbatot. He used to be Mechabed Shabbat. But he had a goy in his vicinity. That he had a lot of properties. Amri Lekaldai, there were certain stargazers that they told him, Kulu Nichse Yosef Mokir Shabbat Achilu. Says all your properties are going to Yosef. So imagine he goes to the stargazers and he finds out that all his properties are going to this Yosef. So what did he do? He said, I'm not going to do that. You crazy? I'm going to give it to the Jew? What did he do? Azal zabninu lekule nichse. He went and he sold all his properties. Vezavabu marganita. And he purchased a pearl, a jewel with it. Very expensive one. Otva besiane. He went and he put it inside of his hat. Okay? With other things. He tied it to the hat. Okay? Ba'adid ka'avre mimbara. When he was passing by the river, a wind came and blew off the hat. The shadya b'maya, and it fell into the water. Bale kavra, and came a fish, and he swallowed it up. Askua, they caught the fish, and they brought it erev Shabbat. They said, the fishermen said, right, what's going to happen? Who's going to buy it now? Saying it's too close to the Shabbat for somebody to come and start buying fish. Amri lehu, right, they told the fishermen, Zilu amtu le gabe Yosef Mokir Shabbat. Go bring it to Yosef Mokir Shabbat. Why? The ragil le zav mizio was used to buy things for lichot Shabbat. Amtu le hal zav ne, he went, he bought it. Kare, he opened it up. The ashke chabe barganita. And what happened was he found the jewel. Zav ne betlesar iliyata dinina nedava. He sold it for 13 attics full of dinarim of zahav. Pagabe u saba, there was a saba that went and said, Amar, Mandiyaziv Shabbata Pare Shabbata. If you borrow on the expense of Lichot Shabbat, the Shabbat itself will pay you back your loans. That means for Shabbat, nothing's gonna happen. You could come, you could use it, and this is actually beautiful because remember, this is tomorrow's daf. This is Erev Shabbat stuff. Right? For Friday. Everything that we learned about we're supposed to do on Friday, Erev Shabbat, and everything that's happening on Friday, we're doing it early. Zizim Akdimin, yeah? But This is Friday's daf.
Right? So we should go to the fish market, or should we wait till the fisher come to us?
Nowadays, I don't think the fishermen are going to come to you unless they always come to you. Let's say, for example, you always buy fish by a certain guy, and you tell him the best fish that you have come to you. So then they'll come to you. Nowadays, no fisherman is just going to come and stop at your door out of no reason. Your reason doesn't exist. Yeah? But either you could go to the fish market, or if you have somebody, right? There's a person actually here in Miami that he sells fish very cheap, and he comes to your house. You make the order, and he brings it to your house already ready. Okay? Fine. If you want, Blinado, when you come to Miami, I'll give you the number.
I will. Thank you.
Ezrat Hashem. Oh, it's actually very good prices as well. So, okay, fine. Ba'mine Rebbe min Rebbe Yishmael Rebbe Yossi. So ask Rebbe from Rebbe Yishmael Rebbe Yossi. Ashirim shu be'eretz Yisrael b'mayim zochim. He says, why is it that the people that are rich in Eretz Yisrael, in what merit do they have in order to become rich? Amar lo, he told them, Yishvin shasim. Because they give ma'aser. They give their ma'aser, shenemar aser te'aser. Aser bishvil shetitasher. Give ma'aser in order that you should become rich. Yeah? By the way, you should know this promise of aser bishvil shetitasher, according to the Gaon Mivilna, only applies if you give 20%, not 10%. If you give 10%, that's midah beronit. You don't get the haftacha that you're going to become rich. You give 20%, you become rich. Right? Shebevavel b'mayim zochim. What are you zoche in Babel? Amar lo, he said, Bishvil shemechabdin et haTorah. He says, because they're mechabed the Torah. Meaning if they're mechabed the Torah, that's why they become rich. Anybody that respects the Torah, they become rich. Amar lo, he said, Bishvil shemechabdin et haTorah. All right, b'mayim zochim. What about in other lands? Amar lo, Bishvil shemechabdin et haShabbat. Because they mechabed the Shabbat. So it's a few things. Ma'aser, Shabbat, and Tamidei Chachamim, the Torah. If you're mechabed one of those three things, you will get rich. That's what's brought down every year. Some people do all three, and that's why they have Lainera, Ko Yosif Lahem, right? That they should have much more, Bezat Hashem. But again, very, very important content. Okay? The Amar of Chia Bar Abba, it says of Chia Bar Abba, Pam Achan Yitarachti Yetzel Barabayit Milutkiya. Once I went to a Barabayit in Lutkiya, if you look at Shulchan Shel Zahav, they brought in front of him a golden table, Masui Shisha Asar Bnei Adam, that needed 16 people to come and to carry it. And they had 13 golden chains tied to it. And they had everything there, everything made out of gold. And it had all types of food. When they put it on the table, Omrim, they said, La'ashem ha'aretz umlo'ah, to Hashem is going to be the land and the world. When they used to take the table away, they said, Hashamayim shamayim la'ashem, ha'aretz natan le'adam, he gave it to us, to his matanot. Amarti lo, he said, Beni, v'ma zachita lakach? What merit did you have? By the way, you should know, there was even a person until today, I remember hearing a famous story, that every single Shabbat, they used to go to a special dining room. And the rest of the house looked like worn down. But when they went into the special dining room, it was something incredible, that they had everything in gold and this and that. Something out of this world. So they said, what were you zocher? Amali told me, Katzav hayiti, I was a butcher. Umikol be'ma shaitana a, amarti zut le Shabbat. Every animal that I saw that was nicer than another one, I said, this is for Shabbat. Amarti lo, I told him, Ashrecha shezachita, fortunate are you that you were zocher, ubaruch hamakom shezikecha lekach, and baruch Hashem that you have this merit. Amar lo kesar le Rabbi Yeshua ben Chananya, one said a kesar, which is like a Caesar, Rabbi Yeshua ben Chananya, mipnei ma tavshil shel Shabbat rechon odef. Why is it that the food of Shabbat has such a good, precious smell? Amar lo, he told him, tavlin echad yesh lanu. I have one tavlin with Shabbat Shemo. Shabbat is his name. Sha'anu matlin letocha, that I put inside of it the food, berechon nodef. And right, that means basically I've got a special tavlin, but the tavlin name is Shabbat, that I put it inside and makes a beautiful smell. Amar lo, he told him, ten lanu emenu, give me a little bit. Amar lo, kol ha'meshamer et ha'Shabbat, mu'il lo. If you're Shomer Shabbat properly, then it helps you. If you're not Shomer Shabbat, it doesn't help you. Which means the Lichvot Shabbat Kodesh only helps if you're Shomer Shabbat. If you're not Shomer Shabbat, it doesn't help you. Amar le'Resh Galuta le'Rav Muna, says le'Resh Galuta to Rav Muna, my dichtiv, what does it mean when it's written? Likdosh Hashem Mechubad, right? Which is Vekarat Hashvat Oneg, Likdosh Hashem Mechubad. Amar le'Zi Yom HaKippurim Shemogolo Chayav Shtiat Kippur. I'm not talking about because you have to put on nice clothing on Kippur. Echibato, what does it mean that you have to honor it? Rav Amar le'Agdim. You have to make it Lichot Shabbat, the Shat HaSeudah Lichot Shabbat, you have to make it earlier. Ushmul Amar le'Acher, to make it later. Right? Why? One of them was saying that you should make it earlier. One of them said because Lichot Shabbat, you're like looking forward to it. And the other one says you should do it later in order that you should eat it with a good appetite. So you're going to be hungry and you're going to eat it with a good appetite. Amru le bene Rav Papa bar Abba le Rav Papa, says the children of Papa bar Abba to Rav Papa, kegon ana neshchiach misa v'chama kulyon. What about us? We have meat and wine every single day. But my, what are you going to do with it? How are you going to be mechabed the Shabbat? Imagine you have people that are very wealthy. Every day they have meat and wine. What are they going to do on Shabbat? Amar lehu, he told them, iregilitu lagdume achuru. If you eat early, eat late. If you eat late, eat early. Meaning even by changing the eating habits, that's in itself enough to be lichvot Shabbat Kodesh. Even if you can't change the food. Because even if there's no delicacies more than that, that in itself is already important. Rav Sheshat, bekaita motiv lul rabbanan echedemat yashimsha. So in the summertime, he used to put the Talmidim in a place where the sun used to come, right? In order that he should go from the, right? That he should get up in order to go to the Tzel. Ah, so that way they would go to the Tzel. But Stav, right? In the wintertime, he used to go in a place where there was basically, it was a lot of sun, right? In order that they should put him in the sun. In order that they should go there, the tzel, kich de lekum haya, in order that they should get up, right? And once they get up, right, they used to know that it's the time for the seudah, and they used to go and quickly eat the seudah. So he purposely, like, you know, timed it in a way that he used to have, whether it's the shade or the sun, now they know it's the time to eat, and then they used to go eat the seudah. But bizerah, right, kuf yutet umbet, hamamadera zuze zuted rabbanan. He used to go after a whole bunch of rabbis on Erev Shabbat. On Shabbat in itself. Amar lehu, he says, so to please, don't be mechalel Shabbat, right? Because the fact that you're being mevatel the oneg Shabbat. That means even though you guys are learning on Shabbat, don't be mevatel the oneg Shabbat. You still have to have oneg Shabbat. Amar Rava says, afilu yachid ha-mipalel b'erev Shabbat tzeich lomar v'chulu. Even a yachid that is praying on Erev Shabbat, he has to say v'chulu. He finished. So you become the partner. That means when we say Vaychulu Hashemayim V'Aretz, we become partners with the Kodesh Baruch Hu. Okay? Again, that's Vaychulu, not the Me'en Sheva. If you're by yourself, you will never say Me'en Sheva, you only say Vaychulu. Amar Rabbi Elazar says, Rabbi Elazar, inayin shad dibur kemaaseh. How do we know that when you speak, it's like an action? Shneimar bidvar Hashem naim yamasu. Bidvar Hashem, with the words of Hashem, the world was created. The Shemayim was naasu, was maaseh. So these words, dibur, became maaseh. Amar Rachastam Rukva says, Rachastam Rukva, kol mipalem Shabbat v'yichulu. Everybody that prays on Erev Shabbat, he says v'yichulu. Shnei malachei Hashem elavim lo la'adam, right? Two people, two malachim, they come and they accompany the human being every Friday night. Malachim is ever shov amrim lo, v'sar avonecha, v'chatatecha tukupan. He says, you should remove the sin from you, and your sins should be forgiven. Okay? So pasuk in Yeshaya. Tanya, we learned in the Braita. Rabbi Yosef Rabbi Yudam, Rabbi Yosef Rabbi Yudam says, Shnei Malachei Hashem Elavim Lo La'adam Be'erev Shabbat, there are two different malachim that they accompany the human being on every Erev Shabbat. Bet Knesset Le'Beto, from the Bet Knesset to his house. Echad Tov, Echad Ra, one of them is good, one of them is bad. U'Sheba Le'Beto, when he gets into his house, and he finds that the candles are lit, the table is set, and his beds are ready. Malach Tov says, Yidat Tzod Shetel HaShabbat HaKach, the next Shabbat should be the exact same way. Malach Ra, Onei HaMemer, Kulchon, the bad Malach has to answer Amen against his will. In love and if not, right? Malach Ra, Omer, the Malach Ra says, Ila Shosh, Ila Shosh, Ba'achere, that it should be like this next Shabbat. Malach Tov, Onei HaMem, Mechol Kpal Kulchon. The good Malach has to answer Amen against his will. I remember once seeing, who are these two Malachim? Okay, here in the footnote it says one opinion is Malach Tov, Malach Ra is Yetzirah, Tov Yetzirah. Ah, the Budaham, he says there's a Malach called Tzadkiel, is a Malach Tov, and the Malach of Ma'adim is Samech Mem, Rasha, is a bad one. Okay, and then that's what I remember. Here it's a Budaham. Okay, it's a Budaham. So basically, do we say that it's because of the Mazal of Tzedek or Mazal Ma'adim? So therefore, he's saying is the last one of Erev Shabbat is Tzedek, and the first one of Lel Shabbat is Ma'adim. Right? Ma'adim is the one of the blood, that likes blood. Okay, which we're going to learn. No, we already learned it. Okay? Fine. Amar Abi Lazar, says Abi Lazar, Le'olam yisader adam shulchano b'Erev Shabbat. A person should always be misader his shulchan on Erev Shabbat. Even though you only need a kazait of bread. Which means, even though you only need a kazait, you're going to set a full table. Right? That's what it should be. Okay? V'am Rav Chia says Rav Chanina, L'olam yitzidar adam shulchan omen Motzei Shabbat v'bi, she'no tzricha l'kazait. The person should always prepare his table on Motzei Shabbat, even though you only need kazait. Again, because of Sudar V'it, which is Melave Malka, you're accompanying the queen out. Chamin b'motzei Shabbat melugma. If you're going to drink hot water on Motzei Shabbat, whether it's to shower or to drink, or also pat chama, hot bread on Motzei Shabbat, it's a refuah. And you should always have a hot tea, a hot coffee, something on Motzei Shabbat, or to bathe yourself in hot water. Plus, pat chama, hot bread. It's also, right? It's important for refuah. Viavu used to make every single Motzei Shabbat, they used to prepare for him an igla tilta, egel meshulash, which is like a calf, right? Third of the stomach. Havach imine kuliata, he used to eat one klaya, one kidney. He gadal avim ibre, when his son grew up, amale, he said, lama lach lafsu, why are you wasting so much meat for one kidney? Mishpo kuliata mala shabbata, right? He says, what? There's already from the animal whatever Shabbat. Vatali achle, right? What happened was, is that he left it over. So what did he do? What happened was, is that a lion came and he ate it. Why? To show you that for Melaveh Malka, for Sudar Revit, you should have an entire new meal. Not to use leftovers, a new meal. Okay? Amar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi, says Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi. This is a new topic now. Right? He says, Kol ha'onei amen yeshem rabba mevarach v'chol kocho, kolino l'gar zardino. Anybody that's going to answer, amen yeshem rabba, right, with all his strength, with all his kavanah, with all his strength, according to Machloket Rashi in Tosot over here, Tosot says, "Bechol kavanato." Chem pirash Rashi, right? The Riomer, right? He used to say that bechol ram. He used to do it strong. That's why in the Kotel, I don't know if you ever saw, there's somebody that comes and he starts screaming like crazy. Amen, yehesh, amen. That's this explanation. Bechol ram, with a very strong voice. Not only bechol kavanato. Okay, so it says, "Kolino gzar dino." We're going to tear up his bad decrees. Okay, Shneimar, but it says in the pasuk, "Bifroa peraot v'Israel." When he's going to annul the bad things, the calamities in Israel, inadev amarechu Hashem. When they're going to come and bless Hashem, ma'il tama. Why is he going to annul the decrees? Even if he has a vodah zera in him, they're going to forgive him. Was the nation when they did the egel azav, they were farua. Okay. Amar Shakish says like Shakish, "Kol ha'onei amen bechol kocho." If you're going to answer amen with all your strength, they're going to answer. They're going to open up the shearim, the gates of Gan Eden. Rather than the answer, amen. My amen, what does it mean, amen? Amen refers to El Melech Ne'eman. It's an acronym. Right? El Melech Ne'eman. And that's why he's fitting to open up Gan Eden. Okay, this is like an extra explanation of what is a men. Because really a men actually could mean two things. Either it's met, or a man can eat its own, but it should be the will of Hashem like that. That's why if you pay attention in the Sidurim, a lot of them actually have amen, and then when it says amen, it has kidusho, whether it's amen can eat its own or amet, or sometimes it's both. It all depends whether it's birkat mitzvot, or whether it's birkat ne'anin, or birkat shvach, and each one is like that. Okay? Pay attention next time in the Sidurim. It's in the Avodat Hashem, Ish Matzliach, you know those Sidurim. Fine, next. Amar Rav Yehuda b'Reded Rav Shmuel b'Shmed Rav. Says Rav Yehuda, the son of Rav Shmuel, in the name of Rav. En adleka mitzviyal b'mkom sheish chilul Shabbat. When is there fires? In a place where there's chilul Shabbat. Shneim Rav says in the Pasuk, Yim lo tishmu elai lekadesh tiyam ha-shabbat l'viti set masa, yitzati esh v'shareya. I'm going to take out a fire. V'achlar menot yushlaim v'lo tifkeh. And it's not going to tichben, it's not going to turn off. Ma'i v'lo tichben, what does it mean it's not going to turn off? It's going to be on Shabbat, so nobody can turn it off. Amar Abaye says, "Lo charva Yerushalayim v'shish chilul Shabbat." Why was Yerushalayim destroyed? Because destroyed of Shabbat. Shleimam shevotai yelimu enhem v'achel otchem etocham. Because they were mechalel Shabbat, that's why Yerushalayim was destroyed. And again, this is the Shabbat of right before Shivasa b'Tamuz. Amar Rabbi Avu says, "Rabbi Avu, lo charva Yerushalayim l'bishvish shemitulu kriyat Shema shachri v'avit." Why was Yerushalayim destroyed? Because they didn't do kriyat Shema in the morning and night time. Shneimar says in pasuk, "Hoi mashkim ya baboker shechar yirdofu." Which means basically we're talking about the people that used to get up, but they used to read it too late. Okay, uchtiv and it's written, "Vayach inor vanevel tov echalil yaim mishtehem vepol Hashem yavitu uchtiv lachen galamim bebli dad." That's why they were actually exiled. Another reason, "Amar avamuna lo chavei shalim yishuv shemitulu batinukot shebet rabban." Why was Yerushalayim destroyed? Because they stopped the children from learning Torah. Shneimar says in pasuk, "Shefoch al olal b'chutz." Matam shefoch, shum d'olal b'chutz. Because the yeladim, the olalim, they're outside, right? Because basically, since they're outside, they're not learning. That's why it was destroyed. Amar ula says, "Look, Yerushalayim mne shalem boshet panim zemizah." They didn't have boshet panim. They didn't have embarrassment from each other. Shneimar hevish k'do v'asuk kibgam. They were doing any types of abominations, and they weren't embarrassed. They were taking bribery, they were doing all these things. They weren't embarrassed of each other. Amar Rav Yitzchak says, you know why Yerushalayim was destroyed? Because they made equal a lesser person and a person of less stature and a higher person. Meaning everyone was equal, equality. And that's a problem. Shneimar v'yach am ka'kohen, chtiv batre, habok tibok ha'aretz. They didn't rebuke each other. That's why Yerushalayim was destroyed. Just like this ram, right? They always go one behind each other, and they only see the zanavim in front. They don't go head to head. They go head to tail. So therefore, they only see the tail of the other one in front of them. So they put their heads in the ground, and they never wanted to rebuke each other. Because if you don't rebuke each other, that's when the problems start. The Amar Rav Yehuda says, "Why was Yerushalayim destroyed? Because they embarrassed Talmidei Chachamim." Ayum Alevim, but it says the pasuk, "Ayum Alevim, Malachei Elokim Bozim." Yeah, the Devarav Mitatim beNevuav Adalot Chamat Hashem beAmo. Until Hashem was very angry. Ad Len Marpo. Until there's no Marpo. What does it mean in the Marpo? Yerav Kolam Vazet Talmidei Chachamim Unifal Makatov. Somebody embarrasses Talmidei Chachamim, they have no cure for their makkah. They have no cure. They come, they start embarrassing Talmidei Chachamim. There's no cure for what they do. Amar Rav Yehuda Merav says, "Rav Yehuda Merav, my dichtiv, what does it mean in pasuk? Al tigum shechav mivat eleo. Do not place your hand on my meshichai, on the ones that are anointed them. Ait umivayel tereu. Al tigum shechav mivat eleo. Tzinu kotshu beter bav mivat eleo. Talmidei Chachamim." Which means, don't start up with the children or with Talmidei Chachamim. Very careful not to be mivatel otam from Torah, or not to go against their kavod. Amar Reish Lakish Mishum Yudan Nesia says Reish Lakish name of Yudan Nesia. Ena olam mitkayem el bishvil hevet tigvot shbet rabban. the entire world is going to be sustained for the hevel of Talmidei Chachamim, the hevel of, sorry, of Tinukot Shebet Rabban, of children, which means that's why we found it so important to make a children's program with learning. And it's costing us a fortune, but it should be Lili Nishmat, Ya Nisim Sultan Membella, and Yitzhak Sultan Ben Esther, right? That it should be, you know, for his tzedakah. But again, the concept is that the Tinukot Shel Bet Rabban, right? It's a very powerful thing. Okay, so Amar Lerav Papa Labai, it says Rav Papa Labai, Didi V'Didach Mai. What about me and you? We're not children, right? And so what happens? Amar Lerav, he said, Eno Dumev Sheish Bochet Lever Shem Bochet. He says, we've sinned. Children, they're pure, right? They don't have the sins like we do. So therefore, that's why it's not the same thing. The children that are learning Torah, we don't even stop them because of Tinukot Shel Bet Rabban. We don't even stop them, sorry, for the Bet Rabban Midash. Building Bet Midash, we don't even stop them. This is what I have from my forefathers. Or some people say from your forefathers, any city that they don't have children learning, they destroy the city. Ravina says machriminota, right? That they don't have any, they completely machriminota. They put it like that they don't have any cherem. They put an excommunication. Some people say that Yushlaim says that Rava was destroyed. Why? Because they don't have people that speak truth. They're going to forget it. Any, is it so? Amar Rav Katina says Rav Katina. Even during the time of the Kishlona, it didn't stop on Shemana. Right, so again, he's saying that there was no Anshemana, and people were all lying, liars. But you should know, by the way, the people that they lie, they always lose out. I've seen it all the time. I've seen people that come, they lie, they mess themselves up, they go back, forth, and their entire life is full of lies. It's like the people, they come, they cover themselves with a blanket. They have it. What does it mean? Right, tachat adicha should be under your hand. We're talking about the limud of the Torah. It says, kufkaf amud aleph. Things which people are not actually paying attention to them, which means in the beginning, they fall into it. And then afterwards, once they fall into it, they're going to know what it is, and they're going to do it properly. Okay? Which means that if you made a mistake, people learn from their mistakes. And therefore, what's going to happen is that they're going to become better. So, B'ezrat Hashem, we continue tomorrow morning, B'ezrat Hashem.